So,
but let me ask you this, though, and this is something I think I heard from you as well, is that the subconscious mind does not care about your dreams or aspirations. It is not built to do that. It is built to keep you alive. It's keep to watch around the tiger around the corner, to drive. Like, and how many people listening have been driving a car and you just start thinking about something and all of a sudden you just go, oh, how did I get here? And you just been driving for 15 minutes and it did turns and parked and you're like, how did I get here? I was thinking about problems or
that, Alex, is the crux of the entire problem, because you just said, look, I've been just driving 15 minutes. I was thinking about all these things. I said, oh, you were thinking. Oh, so I said, then your attention wasn't looking out the window. Correct. It was looking inside. Then I say, what were you thinking about? Oh, I was thinking about doing this and this and this. I go, great. And then I ask this question. What was on the road for that last 15 minutes? You go,
I have no idea
why. I wasn't looking out the window. So then here comes then that problem that I talked about, and that is this. Well, if I'm spending my time thinking or focusing on something completely different, and the subconscious steps in and runs the show, do I see the behavior? I say, no, you're not even paying attention. You're not even looking out the window. You're playing a program. It's a tape. Boom, boom, boom. Tape. That's my age. It's a program. And you're playing this program, but you're the only one that doesn't see it. So same story, 50 years, you have a friend, you know your friend's behavior very well, and you know your friend's parent, and one day you see your friend has the same behavior as their parent, so you just gotta, well, hey, Bill, you're just like your dad. And I said, back away from Bill, because Bill, the first thing Bill's going to say, I already know it. He's going to say, how can you compare me to my dad? I'm nothing like my dad. And the audience laughs. Why they've been experiencing this. And I say, that is the problem. I say, what is it? Bill, behavior is programmed fundamentally by observing his dad. So the subconscious is dad program. When Bill is thinking, he's not looking out the window, but he's playing the program. I say, well, what program? His dad's program. Does Bill see it? No, why not? Bill's not looking out the window. Bill's right. Thinking. Whatever is playing without observation. And so the idea is this. Well, if you're playing behavior without observation and that behavior is not good, then you are manifesting a life you don't want. I go, and there you go. Because we live off of these programs 95% of the day. And a big issue is, of course, this. What are my programs? I go, oh, you got these programs even before you were born. You were getting programs before you were born. You got a program a whole year from 0 to 1. You were being programmed. What program did you get when you were 0? I don't know. Okay. It was programmed another whole year from 1 to 2. What programs you get when you were 2?
No,
I don't know. Okay. Another whole year from 3 to 4 or 2 to 3. And I say, well, maybe around 3, you might remember something. Okay. But up until then, no memory. I say, yeah, but that was all programmed. So then comes the big issue. What are my programs? I go, why? Well, I don't know what they are. They were downloaded before I was aware. And I go, oh, here's the answer. Your life, 95%, is coming from the program. Your life is a printout of your programs. You just look at your life and recognize simple fact, the things that you like that come into your life, they come in because you have a program to acknowledge those things. But the things you wish, desire, want in your life, and you work hard to make them happen, you struggle, you sweat over it. I'm putting a lot of effort in. I'm going to make this happen. Why are you working so hard? And the answer is whatever that destination is, your program doesn't support it. And you're trying to use your conscious, creative mind to override the program. I say, yeah, but conscious mind is 5%. Program is 95%. I go, it's not going to work well at all.
So that's why poor people stay poor and rich people stay rich.
Yep, that's why the book, Rich Dad, Poor Dad, that was exactly what the whole point was. If you grow up with the programming of a rich family, you don't have to think. Programming is subconscious. Your thinking might be quite stupid. I mean, a former president of ours was a relatively rich person, but not very smart in his conscious mind. But his program was, how I got rich? By what? He downloaded that from his family, okay? And if you're in a poor family, what did you download?
To watch the full video, click on the link below. And don't forget to subscribe.